What is up, YouTube? This is Anashi, back with another YuGiOh deck profile video. This time I'll be showing you the changes and updates to my Dark deck. I've been working on this deck for longer than any deck I've owned in this entire game. And if any of you have seen my prior profile videos of this, it's gone through several facelifts and changes. And recently I realized there's a series of cards in the game that happen to be dark and achieve the exact result I've been aiming for in this deck the whole time, and now that I have them in hand, this deck has received yet another amazing upgrade and a new moniker, the Raiders deck. And you'll see what I mean when we take a closer look. Starting with the monsters, we have one Phantom Knight's Ancient Cloak, a staple piece of the PK engine. As a hard once per turn, it can both switch itself to defense to boost a dark monster's attack by 800 until the opponent's end phase, and it can banish itself from the grave to add a The Phantom Knight's card from deck to hand. We have a playset of the Phantom Knights of Silent Boots, the engine's dedicated extender. As a hard once per turn, it can both inherently special summon itself from the hand if you control another PK monster, and it can banish itself from the grave to add any PK spell trap from the deck to the hand. We have a pair of the Phantom Knights of Stained Greaves, a new tech extender for this specific blend. As a hard once per turn, you can both special summon him from hand if a PK monster is special summoned and bump its level up by 1 if you want, and it can banish itself from the grave to special summon a Phantom Knights monster from hand and bump its level up by 1 if you want. We have a playset of Phantom Knights of Torn Scales, the cornerstone of the PK engine. As a hard once per turn, it can both discard a card to send a PK monster from deck to grave, and if a PK card is banished while he's in the grave, he resummons himself but will get banished if he leaves the field. Moving to the level 4 monsters, we have one Armageddon Knight, a classic staple of the deck. On summon, it sends any dark monster from deck to grave, and it's not once per turn. We have one Dark Greffer, just as classic as Arma and a predecessor to Torrent Scales. It can inherently special summon itself from hand by discarding a level 5 or higher dark monster, and once per turn you can discard a dark monster to send a dark monster from deck to grave. We have a playset of Iron Dragon Tiamaton, and while I hate referring to it as such, this is definitely my hand trap of choice for the deck. He can't be summoned normally, but as a hard once per turn, if there are 3 or more cards in any column of the board, he can special summon himself from my hand during either turn. In addition, whenever he is special summoned, he destroys all cards in the column he's in, and while face up, no new cards can be played in this column. We have a pair of Raider's Wing, because one just wasn't enough for me. It's always treated as a Phantom Knights and Raidraptors card, any Dark Xyz monster with his material can't be targeted by card effects, and as a hard once per turn, it can detach a material from any Dark Xyz you control to summon itself from hand or grave, but it will get banished if it leaves the field. We have one Raidraptor Mimicry Lanius, and yes, this means I have officially added a true Raidraptor engine with the Phantom Knights. On the turn it was normal or special summoned, he can increase all Raidraptor's levels you control by 1, and as a hard once per turn, he can banish himself from the graveyard on the turn he went there to add a different Raidraptor card from deck to hand. We have one Raidraptor Singing Lanius, an extender for the Heavy Xyz portion. As a hard once per turn, he can inherently special summon himself from hand if you control an Xyz monster. We have a playset of Raidraptor Strangolanius, a slightly more generic extender. As a hard once per turn, you can both special summon him from hand if you control a dark monster, but you can only special summon dark monsters for the rest of the turn, and if you control an Xyz monster with a dark Xyz monster as material, you can target and resummon any level 4 or lower Raidraptor from your graveyard. We have a playset of Raidraptor Tributelanius, the playstarter for the Raidraptor engine. As a hard once per turn, he can both send any Raidraptor card from deck to grave during the turn he was normal or special summoned, and if he destroyed a monster in battle, then during main phase 2 of that turn, he can add any rank up magic spell from deck to hand, but you can only special summon Raidraptors for the rest of the turn you do this. And we have a playset of Simorgh Bird of Perfection, a convenience extender alongside the other birds. He's also treated as a wind monster, and as a hard once per turn, he can both normal summon himself for free if you normal or special summon a different winged beast, and if he is normal summoned, he sends a Simorgh monster from deck to grave to search a Simorgh spell trap, which I don't run. Next is the spell cards. We have a playset of Allure of Darkness, a standard dark draw spell. Draw 2 cards and either banish a dark monster from hand or discard your entire hand, and it's not once per turn. One Called by the Grave, one Foolish Burial, one Monster Reborn, and we have one Phantom Knight's Rank Up Magic Force, the superior rank up spell. As a heart once per turn, during the main phase, you can banish dark monsters from your graveyard, then target a dark Xyz and Xyz summon a dark Xyz monster whose rank is equal to the original target's rank plus the number of dark monsters you banish to activate the spell. But you can only summon Xyz monsters from the extra deck for the rest of the turn you do this. One reinforcement of the army. Then it's the trap cards. We have one, the Phantom Knights of Shade Brigandine, a convenient searchable extender. It's a type 2 trap monster that can also be activated and summoned on the turn you set it if you have no other traps in the graveyard. We have a play set of Phantom Knights Fogblade, standard equipment for any PK mix. Targets and equips to any effect monster, and that target cannot attack, cannot be attacked, and its effects are negated. And as a hard once per turn, you can banish the trap from the graveyard to target and resummon any PK monster from your grave, but it will be banished if it leaves the field. We have one Raidraptor's Phantom Knight's Claw, for when your Fogblade isn't fast enough. It's a counter trap that detaches the material from a dark Xyz you control to negate and destroy a monster's activating effect. And if you detach a Phantom Knight's, Raidraptor, or Xyz Dragon card, it also gives a Raidraptor monster you control attack equal to the monster that was just destroyed. Next, we move into the side deck, and I have changed up the cards just a little bit. We have a playset of Blizzard, which is designed to answer some of those spell cards that can't be responded to by monster effects. We have a playset of Dark Ruler No More, which was already a staple in here. We have one Harpy's Feather Duster and two Cosmic Cyclone, because I'm not completely sold on the idea of using Lightning Storm in this just yet. We have a playset of Raigeki, for the same reason as the Cosmic and Duster. And we have a playset of Gozen Match to help even out some of those more one-sided games. And finally, we finish up with the extra deck. We have one, the Phantom Knights of Breaksword, the only rank 3 I use. Once per turn, it can detach to target and destroy a card on each side of the field, and if it itself is destroyed, it resummons two Phantom Knight monsters with the same level and bumps them both up by one level. We have one Dark Rebellion Xyz Dragon, my going second offensive option. Double detach to target and cut in half the attack of an opponent's monster and give him the attack it lost permanently. We have one Evil Swarm Nightmare, my going first defensive option. When your opponent special summons, detach one to flip the monster face down, and it's not once per turn. We have one Raider's Knight, a flex rank 4 that serves multiple offensive purposes. It's always treated as a Phantom Knights and Raidraptors card, and as a hard once per turn, it can detach one to Xyz summon a Phantom Knight, Raidraptor, or Xyz Dragon monster on top of itself, whose rank is one higher or lower than him. We have a pair of Raidraptor Force Strix to help push the bird strats along faster and farther. Gains 500 attack and defense for each other winged beast you control, and once per turn, you can detach to search any 4-star dark winged beast from deck to hand. We have one Time Thief Redoer to abuse the existence of Shade Brigandine. During the standby phase each turn, he can attach the top card of the opponent's deck to himself as material, and as a hard once per turn, he can detach any materials from himself at the same time to trigger the following effects based on what was removed. Detaching a monster banishes him until the end phase, a spell draws a card, and a trap stacks any opponent's face of card on top of their deck. We have one Arc Rebellion Xyz Dragon, an OTK generator. He cannot be destroyed by card effects, and as a hard once per turn, he can detach to gain the attack of all other face-up monsters on the field. And if he also has a Dark Xyz under him on resolution, he also permanently negates all other face-up monsters' effects, but only he can attack the turn he does this. We have one Raidraptor Arsenal Falcon, and yes, you know exactly where we are going with this one. Once per turn, you can attach to special summon a level 4 winged beast from your deck. It can attack as many times as it has Raidraptors for Xyz material every turn, and if he is sent to the graveyard while he has a Raidraptor as material, you can special summon a different Raidraptor Xyz from your extra deck and attach him to it as material. We have one Raidraptor Ultimate Falcon, a terrifying Xyz boss for this deck. Unaffected by all other card effects, you can detach to reduce all opponent's monsters by 1,000 attack and prevent the opponent from activating cards or effects for the rest of the turn, and if it has a Raidraptor monster as material, then during the end phase of every turn, either all your opponent's monsters lose 1,000 attack permanently, or if they have no monsters, they take 1,000 damage. We have one IP Mascarena, for the option to switch around my plays as needed. Any link monster using it as material cannot be destroyed by card effects, and as a hard once per turn, it allows you to link summon during the opponent's main phase as long as you use her as material. We have one Raidraptor Force Strix, an extender and enabler for most of the game-ending combos this deck performs. As a hard once per turn, it both special summons any level 4 Dark Winged Beast from your deck when it's Link summoned, but it has its effects negated and you can't use it for Link material. And if you activate a Raidraptor Xyz monster's effect, you can set a rank up magic spell from your deck, plus if it happens to be a quick play, you can activate it that turn. We have one Nightmare Unicorn, because removal is good. On Link Summoned, it discards the target and shuffle any card on the field back into the deck. You get to draw one on resolution if it was co-linked when this happened, and during your draw phase, you get to draw one card for every differently named co-linked nightmare monster you control instead of just one. But this is the only one I run. We have won the Phantom Knights of Rusty Bardiche, the PK boss, and a massive extender. It can't be used as Link material, but as a hard once per turn, it can both send any Phantom Knights monster from deck to grave to set any Phantom Knights spell trap to your field from deck, and if a Dark Xyz monster is summoned to one of the zones it points to, you can target and destroy any card on the field. And we have one Topologic Zeroboros, my personal tech and Link boss for this deck. You cannot special summon any monsters to the zone it points to, but it gains 200 attack for every banished card. If a monster is special summoned to any linked zone, all cards on the field are banished, and once per turn during the standby phase after it was banished by its own effect, it summons itself back. And that is the deck. I know it looks like a really awkward Shun Yuto lore deck, but trust me when I say I worked for a very long time to make this build function, and got a lot of outside help from both archetypal Discord servers. The Raidraptor engine seriously minimized the resources needed to make this deck function, and while the PK engine looks forced in this, it's surprisingly fluid in its combos and resource management. And the bridge pieces between the two, being the Raider's text, just wrap it all up in a nice little bow. All in all, I love this new variant of the deck, I love its consistency buff, and I love that it just acts like a reinforced version of the same dark deck I started with all those years ago. I thank you for watching the deck profile video. If you can think of any ways I can improve this all dark deck, feel free to let me know. In the meantime, this has been Nanashi, signing out. Thank you.